much more, in my opinion, that's happened in the last 50 years. I can move this a little bit so I can see if I'm not standing there. Thanks. So, what do you do? 3 to 5 meals cooked at home, they're delivered to your door. We invest a lot of time in thinking about what we're going to put in the box in terms of recipes and how to put them together into menus. And that, as you can imagine, allows us to basically invest the time of like 5 or 6 chefs and menu planners and folks like that into every dinner that you eat as an individual. So it's a pretty powerful leverage point. And it's a soft subscription model, which means you can set it and forget it, but at the same time, if you want to control it, you can. You can pause it anytime, you can skip it anytime, you can pick your meals, you can set preferences, all that sort of stuff. What does it hit on from a sort of macro perspective? Convenience. Obviously, there's a push for doing more with less from a time perspective across the world, and then also a big push on eating healthier. And also eating real food. There's been a general loss of confidence in sort of the CPG companies and prepackaged foods. So what we send are just actual ingredients. We don't send things that are pre-made with, I mean, very few exceptions. We'll send you mustard, not like vinegar, mustard seed, and